Hi, welcome to my Live2d tutorial. After talking about the eye and the mouth part in the previous episode, this time we will continue with the rest of the face parts. The eyes and the mouth are the main focus of your character, but the remaining parts also need to be separated properly too. Even though these parts may not really have a lot of movement, we have to make sure that everything can be controlled separately. This gives the animator more freedom to be creative. For today's tutorial, we will talk about eyebrows, nose, ear, face, and blush. Eyebrow. In Live2d, you can see there are 8 parameters for the eyebrow. Each eyebrow will have 4 parameters. A few of these parameters will be captured by VTS to follow our facial expression. For my own rigs, at brow left y minus 1, the left brow will go down, and on 1, the brow moves up. With brow left x minus 1, moves the brow to the middle of forehead. 1 will move the brow away from the forehead. A lot of times people don't use brow x. Combined with brow angle and brow form, brow x can make interesting eyebrow movements. Brow left angle is for eyebrow rotation. Minus 1 moves away from forehead, and 1 rotates to center of forehead. Brow L form is the shape of your eyebrow. Minus 1 is for negative shape like angry or sad eyebrow. 1 is for happy or surprised eyebrow. These parameters are also on the outer eyebrow. When you draw the eyebrow, make sure there are not leftover pixel or leftover skin around the eyebrow. Here's a quick demo of how I do my model eyebrow. Nose. There's no nose parameter in Live2d, but we still need the nose parted off from the face for general face movement. Usually, if you use anime style, the nose comes as a dot or have some colored skin. If you have the detailed nose, you can separate it into 3 parts of nose line and separated nose skin. Make sure that part is separated well and clean up from the face skin layer. In Live2d, nose is used on XY angle parameter to make more depth on the face. Left and right ears. Ears are usually covered by hairpiece on the default view, but this hidden part is usually still present on the humanoid model. Sometimes the ears will visible because of the angle of the head or higher piercing. And it might look strange if there are no ears. Exception if your character has animal ears and the client doesn't want to have four ears. When separating the ears, don't forget to fill the hidden parts. Similar with nose, in Live2d, ears don't have their own parameters, but it's important on angle XY head. Depending on the range of your head, the ear will covered by the face and the other ears become more shown. Their ears also make the face angle shown more depth. Elf ears. Elf ears have a same way to separate it like normal ears, but some art style require more cuts. This type need to separate it into front and back ear. Front ear need to draw solid, not a texture skin only. For animal ears, it's more complicated than human ears. Depends of your type of ear, the ear need more than one layer. When drawing the ear, make sure the back ear part is drawn fully. Follow the shape of front ear part. If there a ear fur, should be drawn in full, but not out of the front ear. Animal ears isn't flat. They have more depth than human ear. When do angle hit XY, the ear need show more depth. Face. After handling all the facial features part, the best face skin must clean from other hair or feature parts. So when you make the angle XY, you can move the face skin with more freedom. If there are some leftover parts that are unclean, it will disturb while rigging. Blush. If your character has a layer of cheek blush, either for blushing emotes or expressions, or it's from the best face skin blush, they should be separated from the face skin layer. The reason is, when you rig the angle XY, we make the face rotate to different directions. If the blush sticks to the face, this affects how far we can turn the face before the shape becomes strange. Again, all of this parting, cleaning, and void filling is to give your Live2d animator the best flexibility they can have when they redeem your model. Properly separated layers allow your artist to use the bigger range movements, which will then result in 2D arts that look 3D. If you are interested to learn more, you can buy the Live2d software and use this Live2d coupon for get 15% discount.